prayer and fasting service. So I was praying, touching my wound. I tell God, I said, God, if you do it for this, my friend, I will praise your holy name. I will tell the world that you are Alpha and Omega, that you never change, that you remain the same. For God so good and great, he gave the family a bouncing baby boy. Special number to glorify his holy name, because he is worthy.
his life. Praise the name of the Lord. We are going to anoint ourselves this afternoon. And please, any instructions that come from the altar, you don't joke with it. It is very, very important. When the children finish their duty today, I'm going to anoint them. We hear about a death, Sometimes it may not concern you, but it concerns your religion. There is a dream that I have, and I was speaking to my brother. It's bad, it's not good at all. And it related to accidents. Sometimes there are prayers you pray. You may say all is well with you, but all is not well with your neighbor. All is not well with your relation. What we have just read talks about the anointing. And the Bible says, touch not my anointed and do him no harm. It is your inheritance and your inheritance to live well and not to be troubled. And anyone that troubles you, trouble the Lord. And you ought not to allow it to be. That is why the Bible tells us from the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and only violence men, violence women, take place by force. In Hebrews chapter 1, verse 9, he said, thou hast no righteousness and hated women. So therefore, the Lord has anointed thee with the oil of gladness above the veils. Of Nazareth, magical anointing. It is through the anointing, with the anointing, in the anointing, that you can be able to prepare. Without that oil upon Jesus' life, you can never afford anything. But when the oil comes, it makes way open. Anywhere you stand to, things go well with such a burden. In 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13. The Bible said, the Lord commanded Samuel, go to the house of Jesse and not prepare a gift. That means if the oil will not be released upon them, there is nothing he will do. Neither there is nothing he can produce as a gift. But when the oil comes, no matter how Saul was pushing him all around, at the end, what the Lord has anointed, we have anointed, we get to that position. Before we anoint ourselves, we are going to take a prayer topic and a prayer request. And please, don't look at your neighbor. Don't look at anybody. Jesus started with prayer. Prayer is the key to every situation of life. Without prayer, I and you as a Christian, our faith is nothing. It is prayer that you do with, it is prayer that you move with. And prayer moves mountains. It's unfortunate for some Christians today in our society. When you talk about prayer, they say, leave that thing by the side.
salvation to say from the Bible. John 3 verse 16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Matthew 5 verse 48 says, therefore you shall be perfect, just like the Father in heaven is perfect. Ephesians 6 verse 1 to 3. Children, obey your parents in the world, for this is right. 2. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment you promise. 3. I have a Bible interpreter to say, Hebrews 13 verse 8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. But when she has delivered the baby, she will no longer remember the face from John that the human being has begun to the world.
My name is Victor. My Bible verse is taken from the book of Psalm 31, verse 5. Verse 1 says, Consider all that we do, good things with me. Fight against those who fight for me. Thank you.
And God said, let there be light, and there was light. Genesis chapter 1, verse 19. The evening and the morning were the first day.
I'm giving to you, I'll give it to you now. I know it, I'm can be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay.
Who did God ask to build an ark?
Noah.
And
Our parents should teach us
we should receive kindness. Our parents should be kind to us, should receive love. Our parents should love us because we children were not property for our parents or property of God. We should receive good training and identity. Our parents should send us to school, we should send us to our study, and they should help us in our assignments. Even if they don't know the inner problem with the language or the world type of teachers, they should have another person and teach new children as well. We children should not be treated locally. Our parents should move our little teachers to shouting at us. Because in the book of Ephesians 6, Proverbs chapter 22, verse 6,
he says,
and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Because a time will come when parents will tell God how you took care of your child. Now, children, listen to me carefully. In as much as we receive good treatment, care, kindness, love, good training academically from our parents, we should be able to respect our parents. We shouldn't misbehave. We should do everything they tell us because they don't teach us wrong and they know more than us. So they do it for our good. In the book of Ephesians 6, verse 1, says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. So may the Lord help us to always listen to our parents in Jesus' name. And may the Lord help our parents to continue to treat us well as God's heritage in Jesus' name.
And in all the things I wrote down is what the Lord deposited in this child to give to us this afternoon. It's exactly what I put down that this young man, the Lord put in him to give to us this afternoon. It's a privilege and it's a good thing. You may not understand what we are doing today, but it is a gift from God. Praise the name of the Lord. And he makes a comment here. He said, heritage. And I put it down as he said. He said, heritage simply means property that is or may be inherited. So also it's an inheritance. And heritage simply means, secondly, a special individual possession. It's also an allotted portion. And that is the theme of this, our children, that the Lord has placed in our hands today. Praise the name of the Lord. I am very, very glad and happy to God Almighty for giving them to us and to also answering our prayer to place upon them the wisdom, the understanding, and the privilege that they are enjoying today. And may the name of the Lord be praised in the name of Jesus. The theme of their message is clear to us, for us to understand clearly today, according to the preacher, as they are given to us. He said, children are inherited from God. It's an inheritance. It is something that you ought to understand as a child of God, as a father, as a mother, that the Lord has placed that child in your hands. You should understand it very, very clearly. Because there are so many people today that don't understand this principle. They don't know the gift that God has given to them. Praise the name of the Lord. And in Psalm 127, verse 3, as reported to us, he said, oh, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. Inherited to us. Inherited of the family. And if you return back to Psalm 128, verse 3, he said, your wife shall be as a fruitful plant by the side of your house. Your children, like only plants, run about your table. And that is the reason why, when a woman is not yet pregnant, it becomes a concern to her. And there are some today that have their own, but they don't understand what God If you want to get to your children, then they will be gone. If you don't know, you know this. It is a seed you plant in them that they will become. Please understand this principle. If you have been taking your children to where they are dancing and we don't know their child in the way and the fear of the law, the same way. And that is what the young man is passing to us, parents. Give me the training. Give us the training. So it's an obligated duty. It's a duty that you cannot run away from. And you ought to place it in your mind and in your heart that this is what I will do. These children are indirectly talking to me. Maybe I'm not doing my training very well. So I need to sit up in order to put them in the right way to follow. Praise the name of the Lord. Because they are your property, they are not devil property. So the devil has no control over your lives. Jesus has control over your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I decree from today the hand of God upon you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, after today, every evil hand, in the name of I decree that hand is put down. In the name of the Lord Jesus, anyone that will use evil art against you, I decree that hand blind. By the blood of Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus, children, I decree upon your life, your destiny. Because your destiny is not the hands of the enemy, your destiny is the hands of the Almighty God. And so if your destiny will fulfill. In the name of the Lord Jesus, put on you and our destiny to be a doctor, you be a doctor. Put on you and our destiny to be a lawyer, you be a lawyer. Put on you and our destiny to be a minister of the gospel, you be a minister of the gospel. In the name of the Lord Jesus, in this foreign land you shall excel. I decree upon your life, you will be obedient to your children. You will not be a wayward children. You will not be disobedient children. In the name of the Lord Jesus, the devil will not use your instrument. For God will bring his instrument in the hand of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Lord, become what the Lord has sent you to this world to do in the name of Jesus. No power, no hands will stop me in the name of Jesus.
You are blessed. 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 In the name of Jesus, I decree upon your life, as the forthcoming old generation of this world, you shall do as well. You shall capture kingdom for your parents. You will bring glory to your parents, to the entire body of the world. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. You are covered and protected in the name of Jesus. No power shall throw you. As of today, you pray the man of God. Let my cover. Thank you once again for answering prayer. For in Jesus Christ's name, we will pray.
Thank you. using as an instrument to prepare these children for the kingdom in the way of God and in the fear of the Lord. Lord God, we ask, O God, for your grant of protection upon our life and our household in the day of the Lord Jesus. Father, with this covenant anointing, we are able to pray for her that the peace of God will abide her marriage. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you continue to use her as an instrument in leading the Grand Bible Church to prepare the children for the kingdom. In the name of the Lord Jesus, and as we pray for our report of these children, that these children, they will do well in life. In the name of Jesus, academically, they will do well. In the name of the Lord Jesus, they will lead people ahead. They can wish upon all these children, none of them will be sick. In the name of the Lord Jesus, they will live behind. Anyone that tries to throw arrow of sickness, it will recover to center. It will recover to center. In the house of the Lord, forever and ever. Amen. I want you to walk to somebody, tell your heart that this month will favor you. We want to prepare this month will favor you.
I mean, no, I said to you.